when I come to here, I saw a lot of people like football. Why do you think American, the people in America, they play football? Do you know the reasons?
They're crazy.
Crazy, yeah. Nah.
I just kept hearing your name. Something just kept saying, Allen, 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 Allen. And every time I would hear your name, Allen, I would just think about how strong you are, how fast you are, how physical you are. There was a small portion in my heart, a small portion in the back of my mind that was saying, does this kid really know what he's getting himself into?
The second year I joined the football, because he told me that he played football in college and like those stuff. And I was like, boy, want to play like the real man sport. I like to attack people.
That's why
I joined the football team.
接触橄榄球这项运动是我来美国第二年的时候，因为第一年刚来，不怎么熟悉，也没有那么多精力说的去打橄榄，因为当时根本就不了解什么是橄榄球。然后第一年我有跟朋友去看过那种我们学校橄榄球比赛，当时坐在观众席上，就感觉就像我完全不知道说他们在干什么，那个人为什么有的人跑，有的人在撞人，就完全搞不清状况。但是从心里面，从打心里说，我是特别想打这项运动的，因为作为我的性格来讲，我从小就非常爱运动，在中国也是经常打篮球，也身体素质还可以，就是对。然后我就想，我有机会我一定得打橄榄球。上半身最主要就是整个全身看来最主要的护具就是这个头盔，因为橄榄球非常激烈的冲撞，你不知道什么时候你就会跟别人就有人来防守你或者来撞你，所以说头一定要保护好，所以说头盔是最主要的。还有这个是 shoulder pad， 就是说保护你的胸以上这个范围，因为平时别人撞你都是以就是用你肩以下的部位去跟你冲撞，所以说这个是保护你的整个胸到肩膀这一段。然后一般这两个护具就是打橄榄球加上其他配套的鞋子、袜子、护膝之类的，总共橄榄球赛季的时候我们每个队员交了大概是400多美金，所以说对，这大概的在高中大概价格就是这样子，400多美金。你如果要参加橄榄球队的话，他会给你一套这样的服装，然后去训练。其实你别看这东西其实很重的，像一般很多人说啊，我跑得很快，跑得很快。如果说跑得最快，在橄榄球运动员里面跑得快的意义是不是说你脱掉全身比谁100米冲得快，是你穿上所有的装备，穿上盔甲之后，你还能跑得最快，那才是真正说你跑得快。对，对，这是一个非常重要的，对，把它加紧。
I practice with you guys all summer because I have summer school here.
Right.
I wake up at 5 in the morning so I can get to the weight room at the 6,
right.
6-ish, so right. 1 hour weight room training. Mm-hmm. So after school, 4:30, and then we're doing the running on here field. Mm-hmm. So that time is like, it's big challenge for me.
第一年的暑假一个多月都是在跟着队伍训练橄榄球，那时候我家里人他肯定很赞同，说你两个月，你一年没回家了，两个月说你不回家，你在美国跟别人训练橄榄球。当时我爸我妈两个人是完全不支持我说的要去打橄榄球。为什么呢？他们因为大家都知道，就算看比赛不了解的人都知道橄榄球他的身体冲撞真的是非常非常厉害。我妈说啊，你一个中国人，你去跟人家啊吃的那么壮的白人黑人在那边死撞行不行？然后我撂了一句，我说我们中国人也是有很强壮的，好吧，我就是其中一个。然后我就这样跟他们开玩笑。
What football is all about? It's not just you are big, you are huge, you can run, you play football. No, if you don't know what to do, you will be like idiot on the field, right?
我的位置，因为你知道打橄榄球跟篮球不一样，不需要很大的身高，所以像我打橄榄球我其实还是有优势的。为什么？因为教练给我的位置是跑锋。看比赛看到一个人他抱着球冲向人堆里面要死命的往前冲的那个人就是跑锋，那个位置可以说是橄榄球当中得分最重要的位置，因为也是可以说是受伤最重要的位置。当传球手把球递到你的手里的时候，你的任务就只剩下一个，你是拿着球，不管前面有多少人撞你，你 都得往里面去冲。所以说你经常会看到一个人拿着球往所有队里面，往所有的人堆里面冲，然后就被压在底下。对，那就是跑锋，那就是教练给我的位置。我当时没有，我接到我当时教练说给我打跑锋的位置，我是非常开心的。我现在想起来，我都不知道为什么自己那么开心。在别人眼里看来啊，那是一个非常危险的任务，说不定你被一撞你就对很多意外。但是我是非常的开心，因为可以说很多大个子、大个子、大胖子在前面，他都是为我们得分手，他们可以说是一个人墙，挡住对方的防御，让我们这种小个子有机会说拿到球，跑得越远越好。如果说你能跑到对方终点线，你就得分了。
The hardest thing that I faced for me, I would say, I get to remember all the play.
Right.
So okay, for running back, I need to remember all the play, like 32 King, right?
Right.
34
right,
or something like that, and I need to know what gap I need to run to.
Right.
So at first, I have no idea what I need to do. So every time I like run the wrong way, I need to go left. Okay, I get the ball and I go right.
Right.
So coach was so mad at me.
Right.
And also the language things.
Right.
It's a problem for me to understand a lot.
我回来了，上学。不要。Time.
Time and place. The number of Chinese students I have in the classroom, ordinarily, I'm going to make certain accommodations to help them with the language assimilation, because there's going to be a lot of words that they're unfamiliar with. So one of the things I do to help my students is watch my pacing first off. I'll try to make sure I'm not talking or speaking too fast.
We have a plot line up here. Can anybody tell me what's the first thing that's going to be on that plot line? Alan?
Start with exposition.
Exposition, that's right. And what do we get in the exposition?
Background, character, conflict.
And I remember you when you first came to class. Even, you know, you took a little time to get you going. You know, you weren't necessarily up to speed right off the bat. All right, I remember, you know, I think there's maybe a few times where, you know, you didn't turn in your assignments on time. I think
binder chat.
Yeah. I mean, nothing huge, but enough little things that were hurting your grade in the beginning. And you probably weren't preparing for your test as well as you could have in the beginning either. But over time, you finally got the swing of things and you started to, I think once you started to get acclimated to your environment altogether, and you started to see the importance of utilizing English every opportunity you had, particularly by the time you moved in with the Sturgers, you were, you know, I think at that point for sure you knew that, oh, I need to be utilizing English all the time. So when you were with them, you were probably speaking English at home, and you were probably using English when you were looking at the internet and what have you. And I noticed a real increase immediately by the time you'd moved in with them. Your test scores went up, and you were consistent with your homework. I still think maybe you might have missed a day or two more than I cared for as far as overall days of school, but you definitely, you know, improved overall in both homework and assessments. So that was really nice to see.
I never think you play a sport, you need to take a note. Okay, I never thought about that, but when I joined the football, I know, okay, I need to take a note. So I draw the play, I take a note, and it's like we're having a test, right?
Right, we're also
having a test.
Right.
Dude, I never think you play a sport, you need to like work hard as study, like get an A on the grade, on the class.
Right.
英语有很大的影响，大家 70%-80%都是张嘴就是这个中国。
这个学校很多外国人都是在那个橄榄球队里面的，就是说一般中国人很少参加橄榄球队，而且就大多数这学校70%-80%是中国人，那少数的外国人他都是在橄榄球队里面，因为他们是一个，就是他们加入橄榄球队等于说是拿那个奖学金打橄榄球到学校来上学，所以说免费的，大概是这个意思吧。所以说你队里面打橄榄球的很多都是外国人，只有少数的亚洲人，对，中国人，还有一两个韩国人吧。很多人也许会说，橄榄球，打橄榄球到底他们的乐趣在哪里？但是你如果说真的没有什么意义的话，你说这项运动在全美国能够有那么久的历史，可以说成为美国的国球，像我们中国乒乓球一样，那肯定是有它的原因的。所以当你没有亲身经历，你不知道它所谓的橄榄球它的意义在哪里。但是在我经历了这人生中一年打橄榄球的经历，我觉得我学到许多许多的东西，这些东西可能有的人说真的他一辈子都不会去体会的。对我来说，我觉得最重要的可以告诉大家的就是他对你意志方面的，你对你的毅力可以完全说是一个非常大的挑战。不知道有多少人在就是说赛季打到一半中途退出橄榄球队，这种例子可以说是数不胜数。为什么很多人在中途吃不了那种苦啊，或者说被受伤特别严重，所以没有办法继续打下去的特别多。打篮球我们都知道，篮球是非常需要团结的一项运动。然后别人就说那橄榄球呢，我可以这样告诉你，橄榄球比篮球团结100倍甚至不止。为什么？打篮球5个人在场上，橄榄球是一个队，虽然说可能说你看哦是一个人跑去得分了，但你要知道很多人其他的队员都是在为那一个人做贡献。当你所有的传球手接球手旁或者说在前面为你挡住防守的那些巨大的运动员，他所有队伍的任务只有一个，就保护自己对方的队友，保护自己的队友，让对方的队友没有机会去攻击我们的队友，所以说我们整个队能得分。所以说这是一项完全特别需要动脑筋、需要团队配合的运动。那有人说了啊，动脑筋，我觉得很多人会说，看着电视上面那些五大三粗的男人说橄榄球要动脑筋，开玩笑，你不就是谁涨谁吗？谁涨谁？我可以这样跟你说，当我真正接触到橄榄球之后，它是第一项运动，就是说我要用笔记去把每一项战术记下来的运动。但然而我们队还有每周三，那个时候每周三放学之后训练比赛之前都会有一个考试，对，考橄榄球。教练会给我们一张纸，把我们的那种每一次的战术训练，每一个人要走的位置，像前面防守人是对那个队员进行防守，还是说你接球手跑左边跑右边，这全部都是有战术的。所以说我们每周都会有一个考试，叫你有没有记住所有的战术。当你记住所有的战术之后，你才会说有机会，教练说让你去上场。如果说你那个考试没有过，对不起，比赛没有一分钟的上场机会。因为你要知道在橄榄球战场其实就是一个战场。当你一个人做了一件错事，比如说前面的防守队员没有说该去挡住他的防守队员，那个人空了之后，对于我们跑锋来说只能面临一个结果，跑出去被人撞了。所以说每一个人在橄榄球队里面都是非常重要的。教练一直这样说，我们所有的队员让这橄榄球队有机会，不是说你一个人的个人能力可以让整个队获得胜利。你训练结束啊，很累。每一次训练完，每天都有两个多小时的训练，两个半小时的训练，非常累，但是我觉得是值得的。因为在我就是说喜欢运动的男孩子心里都有一个 一个做运动员的梦想，而我有这个机会来到美国经历打橄榄球这项运动，我觉得这是非常值得的。就算你知道有的时候会受伤啊。
Do you remember when I get hit like very bad? Like I never broke any part of my body.
Right.
So okay, I broke my left wrist.
Right.
Yeah, during the season, like the last game.
Yeah.
I immediately thought to myself, man, dang, he broke his hand. He's gonna quit. He's not gonna play no more. It's all over. His mom's gonna call from China and says, man, I don't want him playing, etc. But I remember I got a call from you saying, you know, or seeing you the next day at school, and you saying, man, I want to practice. I want to practice. I'm like, man, here's a guy who took a hit, you know what I mean, and got every reason to walk away from the game. Look, I'm injured, no more. But you said, no, even though I'm injured, I still want to play. I still want to practice. And I think that that just showed a lot. That showed a lot about who you are, your character.
有一场比赛。别人把我手撞到我的手腕，就是我在防守别人，我想去那个 tackle 别人的时候，有个人，对方防守队员来 tackle 我，我没看到他整个人扑到我身上，然后头盔重重的砸到我的左手上面，然后那一次我就是当时我的手腕是没有感觉的，然后我就躺在场上了，然后我就被教练换到场下，然后。那时候因为在比赛中，我教练问我能不能动，我说还可以动，然后大家以为都没事，然后当时就一直忍着疼痛，就敷着冰。比赛结束之后，大概过了两天，因为我觉得我一般从来没受过大伤，我觉得那两天时间，我就自己天天用冰敷，涂点药，但两天之后还是很疼，那时候我才意识到说的得去医院看一下会怎么样。然后我的助教带我到医院一看，然后拍了 X 光片。显示我的这边这根骨头是断的，但然后当时我从小到大长那么大，虽然说受过伤，跌破过，撞到过，划破过，但是从来没有说身上哪根骨头断过。对，然后这就是我第一次断了一个手腕，也是橄榄球给我的，但是我从来没有说去怪过，去后悔怎么样啊？因为橄榄球我受伤。从来没有，像那段时间我手断那段时间，戴上那个重重的石膏，我在这边瞒了我父母，在中国瞒了将近将近两个多星期，因为他们跟我视频的时候，我都只对着我的脸，你知道吗？后来我妈发现说，哎，儿子，你为什么这几天视频都对着你的脸？然后我就没有说什么。后来我的住家因为这事情也不是一件什么小事，就偷偷的跟我妈。发了一封邮件，然后我妈那天跟我视频上来，一上来就冲我把我骂了一顿，因为我妈说你小子在那边，她当时的心情是恨不得就飞过来，你知道吗？飞过来看我，因为我也理解从小都很惯我，没受过那么大的伤，直接就说你骨头断了，我妈肯定很担心，我爸倒还好，我爸都没有说什么，但我妈就非常的担心，对，然后我就当时安慰我妈，我说没有关系，就是手断了。我说男人嘛，哪个人没有说断过一根骨头什么的？然后就带着那个石膏，那段时间可以说，是我生命中我觉得是最难忘的时光吧。
In my life, like I would say, yeah, come to America and play real football and get hit,
right,
break a bone. All right, that's my life.It's my high school life.
Right.
And after that, the basketball season is coming soon, right?
Right.
Do you remember I wearing a cast and go to the basketball practice with you guys? You know, I just don't want to miss anything because I want to like get to play like right away when I took off my cast.
Right.
And the first day when I took off my cast, I told you, I want to play the basketball game.And you said you didn't working for the hand like for a month, right?
Right.
But I just want to play basketball too much at that time.
What?
I'm so happy to see you.
Oh, they got that on camera.
I don't care.
Hi.
I miss you so
much. I'm a new
much.
Student here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
So we're gonna...
No.
How you doing?
I miss you. I have a letter for you.
Right now?
Yeah.
They're gonna give me later.
Take it.
Mikey!
Take it. Take it.
Where?
It's a start, man.
Oh.
This?
No.
This?
The paper that says your name.
I know. Hey, Mike.
What's
up? What? You already gave me a hug.
I don't care. No, man. I love you. Oh, I miss you. Oh, I miss you so much, man.
What are you doing here?
Back to school?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just kidding.
So you got cameras?
Yep.
So we don't go to class? Well, Mike will not.
Who's this?
Huh? Your girlfriend? No.
I'm just kidding, bro. Just,
why? What are you doing?
Because that taking a documentary.
Hi, Mikey.
Documentary?
Yeah.
Why? Hi, I'm Alan. I'm Alan's best friend. I'm Alan's best friend. My name's Jason.
I love Alan.
Oh!
Alright,
see you later.
See you later.
I'm gonna go to your class.
Oh, I'm gonna turn in my homework.
Wait, it's Mr. Lu's class, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna turn in my homework.
I'll be there. Okay.
Oh,
what?
Hey. Yeah, I know. I know who this is.
I know. I'm sorry. Sean.
What's up,
bro?
I was your first friend, right?
I know. He's my first friend when I come to the school. Yeah. Football. What's up, Raymond?
You Alan, come here, man.
How's basketball? Basketball going?
Alright.
Starting it?
Yeah.
Already start?
Practice, yeah.
You guys need me. I know, you guys need me.
Hi!
I see something with you, though.
Yeah, me too.
I actually typed my letter for you. So I don't know why I never
typed
it.
No, I need your handwriting.
Okay, I have to copy it all over again, because I lost the first copy.
Oh, that's fine.
Let's hang out.
我在这边最好的女生朋友，她叫 Ada。哎，操，你头发很帅啊！头发很帅啊，帅。
现在老比丘。
对，我最好的女性朋友，对，美国人，但是中国人生在美国，对。对我非常的好，我们俩非常的好的朋友。对。
对。Thank you, Lily.
Thank you.
Of course, it's kind of weird because it's like before.
I know, you forget it. 他是我一个非常好的朋友，对我好朋友。Come here.
What?
好朋友，然后。我们经常出去啊玩，有的时候上次他陪我看，我们一起去看电影的，对，对我非常好。
All right, drop.
放学了。
放学。
你这衣服不错。
最近练的
怎么样？这两个也是我以前上学这边玩的最好的中国的朋友。这个鸠梦非常高，跟我打篮球，老一起打篮球。
学校怎么样？
啊，这个是。啊，广东的歌神唱粤语歌特别好听，真的。
学校
四个中国人，我们年级就我一个。没有，我没有这样想。对，我好好学习去。
让他麦克森找你去那
场。嗯。
麦克森在找你。
谁？
麦克森。去了吗
？Bro。Bro。
How you been, man?
Good. I like your glasses.
Oh, thank you. They're my dad's actually. I stole them from him.
So, we're going to practice? Are you going to go practice?
I can't play.
I know. You're saying being a coach, right?
No, not for football. For baseball, man. For football season, I'm just working out.
Just working out? Like buff as me? As buff as me?
Getting as buff as you.
Yeah, you know,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I hit those two plates. Yeah.
这个已跟我一起打橄榄球，去年对跟我一起打橄榄球的 quarterback 就最重要的扔球的那个传球手。
Yeah, quarterback.
Quarterback.
Yeah.
Yeah. When I first year come here,
my English is poor, so I don't have a lot of people to talk to. She know a little bit Chinese, and so she start talking to me, and it's my first like real friend here, and she teach me a lot of English, and she asked me to hang out and help me a lot. So we're going to movies, right?
Yeah.
Say, what?
To beach ones.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Do you remember the first time we meet?
Yeah, at the spiritual explosion, right? I told you.
Do you remember what you did?
I did? I don't know.
You were like, Ada! And then you're like, and I come give you a hug. It's pretty cute.
I saw you forget it.
No?
Because I told you that, yeah.
Yeah.
You gave me the first hug in America, yeah.
Yeah, because remember when the first time we met, you were in
Soul Match
shirt?
Yes.
And I was wearing
a
shirt.
We got a like couple t-shirts, because you say it.
Yeah, like when I first saw him, he was wearing a Superman shirt, and I was also wearing a Superman shirt that day, so I was like, oh my gosh, like.
Yes, that's so why, and I add her on Facebook, so we started talking, and make a friend, and she's still my friend right now.
Yeah, he's like my best friend.
Yeah, best friend.
You want it?
It's pretty good.
I know. I hope you go to a good college.
I know you
will. I mean you.
I know you will too.
And maybe we'll see each other there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or you can come drive over to my college.
So, not out of state, right? Maybe.
Maybe.
I
know you want to stay here.
Fine, I just don't know yet. 就我跟他成为朋友之后，我们打招呼的方式就是，就这样。然后他教我的，我觉得特别酷吧。然后他非常非常好玩的一个人，他喜欢学中文。那时候我们老教他一些中文嘛。啊，对。I teach you some Chinese. Do you remember?Yeah? You like learn Chinese, right?
Yeah. Alan here is, I forgot how to say it in Chinese, but he's awesome.
Say some Chinese.
Yeah. That means handsome, right?
Yeah, do it.
Ta hen shuai, right?
Yeah! I didn't teach that. 我没有教他那个，他发自内心说出来。Again.
Yes.
Again.
超很帅，
耶！
我很帅。
喂，他说他很帅。不是我很帅，他说他很帅。
高富帅，
他很帅是他很。
喂 ，again。
高富帅，
高富帅。对，我们把这些都交给他，他都蛮记得住的。
高富帅，我在做翻译了。
Yes。Yes。Hi, man.
Awesome, best memory. I mean, when I took off my cast, my hand is like still pain.
Right.
So I feel a lot of pain. So I got a tape, you know, wrap
right.
my hand up.
Right.
So every game I'm wearing a scenes and go to a game. I mean, after that, I was thinking, yeah, myself is really brave. I mean, I'm a real man. I was playing.
We've got a lot of new students that have come in, a lot of students from China, as always, because of this area. You know, the city of Walnut has a lot of immigrants from China and also from Korea,
yeah.
And then from other different areas of Asia.
So the school every year gets a new influx of good Asian students, and we like that because Asian countries have a high value in education, just like your mom and dad do. And because of that, we get students that come here and they. You know, they have real strong goals of going to a good college in America, and they come here and they work hard, and it's not easy for them because they have to learn all the English and all that, but
yeah.
But they have the goals of getting to a good college, and so they have a good vision, and it helps them to work hard in class, and so we really appreciate that. It's a college prep school, so that's what we're about getting students into great schools. And here in Southern California, you know, a lot of the students like to go to UC Berkeley, UCLA, and Stanford, and schools like that. And that's the kind of academic program that Southlands has put together. And it's one of the benefits of being here is you get prepared for that kind of schooling. And I think one of the other things that's really beneficial for students coming from China is, you know, Southlands has a big international program. And because of that, we're able to service international students very well. And so when you guys, just like when you came in, you know, you tested into the English program and made your way up through it and got into the regular classes and got on your way to, you know, your English got great, and then you could move on and do your APs and all that. But we were able to take students through a system instead of throwing them into a school environment that's not really suitable for them. We're able to stick them into a language program and work them up to where they're really ready for it. It's Los Angeles, it's very international. And especially around here, we have a big Asian community. And I think that's really, really good for students like you and your friend, because, you know, when you move from China to America, you miss
family.
You miss family.
You can make a lot of friends, yeah. You know. Yeah, it's like easier to find a friend that you want to, like, make another new friend.
That's right.
But you can make easy friend from start from here.
That's right. And but I think even that's very important. But one thing that's maybe even more important to Chinese people, mm-hmm. Americans, we miss home with our heart. You miss it with your stomach.
Yeah, Chinese food.
So you
right?
can get all the Chinese food you want. It's right here with you. And I think that's really important because it helps to have a taste of home and a taste of America. And we're a good blend here. And we help kids make a bridge into America so that they can move on into college into another place. So you are one of our success stories. And I think the reason why you were so successful in coming to America is because you're very aggressive with wanting to blend into the environment here. And that's really not that easy. You know, a lot of students come here and it's very easy to make Chinese friends and just speak Chinese and kind of stay in your own culture even though you're in America. And you did the opposite. You know, you dove in, you worked hard on your English, you tried out for football, which is probably the most American sport that there is. You know, you tried out for football and you went out and you did well and you learned from that. You also played basketball and you worked with the coaches and you became very American. And not just culturally do Americans like that, but I think also academically, that helps you a lot because you learn you learn English very well.
Yeah.
And one of the biggest things that makes students successful is academic English, because you're in the classroom, you're talking about subjects in English, and you're very smart anyways, but you need the language to be able to talk about it.
这种, 亚洲人居住的城市, 你看到一些, 外国人, 你会觉得很不习惯, 有的时候, 就是说, 诶, 怎么还会有外国人生活在这里? 但这也只是一个玩笑了, 毕竟这是美国嘛, 但是这边是绝大多数居住的是中国人, 和韩国人。 我们这座学校, 我当年是通过中介来的, 但第一年就是我也不了解这个学校的整体情况, 所以说我当年听说这个学校国际学生不少, 但我不知道会有很多, 所以说当我来到这里之后才发现, 啊, 有一大多数, 有一半可以说是中国人, 在我第一年来的时候, 所以说我当时, 说真的的感受可以说是非常的, 失望吧, 失落, 可以说失落, 因为我没有想过说我从中国来到美国, 到了一个高中, 是那么多中国人在一起, 因为我没有想过这种事情, 也没有觉得真的会这样耶, 那我还不如在中国上高中算了, 但是这是我当时第一个心里最真实的反应, 但是在你几个月之后, 慢慢的适应了很多中国的朋友一起, 聊开了, 那也就我觉得算了吧, 那就在这边上吧, 也没什么不好, 然后就这样, 当时我有过转型的念头, 在第一年来的时候, 但是可以说因为什么, 因为, 随着, 你知道吗, 很多时候随着时间, 时间慢慢的过, 你就会觉得, 啊, 许多事情算了吧, 就这样算了吧, 叫做随遇而安嘛, 也是, 对, 然后我就算了, 就一直在这边上, 上了两年, 这个学校, 你可以看, 在整个房子都是非常的矮, 因为这是一个, 整个加州都是一个地震区, 特别是这个区域, 它是很多山, 很, 就是说, 很多小山丘, 所以说一般的房子都不会很高, 像这种教室就是最普通的房子, 一层, 我们学校最高的房子就是我们的体育馆, 对, 它稍, 它也是一层, 但是稍微高了一点, 因为是体育馆嘛。 然后这个学校, 因为, 国际学生比较多，所以美国气氛不是特别的浓。但是有一点保持很好，就是它整体它的运动就是体育气氛还是蛮好的，因为学校很多人喜欢，中国人都喜欢打篮球很多，然后也有美国人过来，在我们学校是橄榄球队的，所以说整个学校的气氛可以说是，你每天下课都会看到很多人一起打闹打篮球啊。像我可以回忆的是，当年我在这上学的时候，中午吃饭好像有30分钟多吧，30多分钟。那我们有的时候几个中国朋友一起就会5分钟把饭吃完，然后剩下的时间在那边打篮球。那对，其实这种时光我觉得就跟在中国很像，然后现在想起来也非常怀念，就是说那时候匆匆忙忙跟朋友吃完饭，然后在这里肆无忌惮地打着篮球，然后有的时候我们会吵架，真的是中国人在一起打篮球时间打久了之后就会觉得啊，我这边没犯规，你那边犯规了。对，都题外话。总体来说是，这是我在这里上了2年的高中，给我很多回忆。但是在最后一年我选择离开，我其实对是有我自己的原因。我觉得在我人生当中，高中就这几年的时间，我来到美国，我希望自己能够真正意义上的去接触一下真正美国高中它的真实的生活，真实的那种环境。所以说我觉得在我有机会的时候，我应该尝试，应该去挑战，因为毕竟你知道中国人多了，你的语言提高能力就不会说那么快，因为很多中国人在一起我们都会说中文啊，说英文会很奇怪，有的时候就会上课说英文，你下课一起玩的话都会说中文。到最后我其实想想，因为第一年已经有这想法没有去转，但是在最后一年我又想到这个想法的时候，我真心在内心真正的问我自己，是不是应该这样做。然后我在想，如果说我做了，如果说我不去做，我肯定会去后悔。那我的性格，我说我不想让我说这一辈子说已经做过很多后悔的事情了，那我这件事情不做，那肯定又会后悔。所以对，做吧。我觉得最后一年转学也没什么大事儿，我觉得去适应一个新的环境，去挑战自己有什么不好的。加油吧，最后一年争取考一个好的大学。然后对，这就是我所希望的。
Some students come and they don't really want to be here. They don't really have a purpose for being here. And so they are not as successful. However, with you, you had a goal.
Yeah, okay.
You came with a goal. You came with a purpose. And so you knew from the very beginning what you wanted out of your school here. And I think that was something that made you a lot more successful than other students that came without a vision. And so I think that focusing on what you really want out of your experience here has been what's helped you to be successful.
I got a lot of friends, they come, maybe their parents want them to come here.
Uh-huh.
Or some student come just wherever, they just come.
Right.
So yeah, for me, I think the reason why I come here is because I want to have the good education.
Okay.
You know, because everyone knows America's education is very high level in the whole world. So that's why I want to come here for high school. So that may give me advantage that getting to good college here too.
So it was your choice in that you wanted to come here for a better education,
yes.
Not just because your parents sent you and said,
no.
Go get an education.
No.
Okay,
yeah.
That makes a big difference.
Chinese agency, they gave me like 3 options saying there's 3 families that I can choose for. And I see the family's pictures,
uh-huh.
And then I choose you guys because I saw you guys having a family pictures in the kitchen.
Right.
And it's pretty good.
Yeah, so.
I saw the big kitchen, that's why it's okay. I'm gonna,
so you chose us for the food now.
Maybe, yeah.
Have we met that expectation?
It's very met.
Good
very
cooking?
Met. Yeah, good cooking. That's why I feel very happy to stay.
Action.
Okay. Hey, Alan. Let's go get the meat.
Meat?
Yeah.
So, are you doing the barbecue today?
Yep, it's barbecue. We're getting pork shoulder, cooked for 14 hours. Could you help us bring it in?
I saw it as beef.
No, it's pork right on the shoulder.
So, okay, so how long is cooked?
14 hours. We started 2 in the morning when you were in bed.
2 in the morning?
2 in the morning.
Oh, I was falling asleep.
Be careful, it's hot.
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Okay, looks good.
Whoa.
Yep, it's done. So we'll bring it in and we'll put it on this. It's really good. Thank you. This is from the southern United States where they took lesser cuts of meat and cooked them a long time so that it got real tender.
其实就是在这边吃饭我还是蛮适应的因为我喜欢吃肉然后他们家里就是每天有的时候吃鸡啊吃猪肉这次烤的猪肉有的时候烤牛排之类的所以我在他们家吃饭都非常的适应吧然后有的时候没有饭就吃土豆泥啊然后弄点玉米啊然后对然后每天都吃很好然后每次回国别人都说我壮了
Can you help me with the setting the table? So, how'd everything go at school today?
Woo!
That wasn't supposed to happen, sorry.
It's alright. It's pretty good. I mean, I met some new friends. Yeah, it's totally new for me.
And
he normally sits there.
No, he doesn't. Leah always sits there. The only two people where they're supposed to be are Alan and Leah, because they always sit there. Okay, so let me get the bread. All right, let's. Can I pass the bread? Here, you take the bread first.
Take one.
Pass the mustard sauce, please.
Sweetie.
Thank you. All right, mustard sauce first.
So put
a
sauce on the bread.
Sauce on the bread. Here you go.
All right. More or just
a little? Oh, I like a lot. It's really good.
That's separable pieces. That's good.
It's okay. Yeah. All right. It's a little hot. Okay.
Hot?
Yeah. And
it's
then
got
you.
A little spicy.
Are you ready? Then you put meat on. You do your meat. Okay. Alright. Now, you can eat it the first way, the right way, and then you can do whatever you want. Eat it however you want. But one time you're going to do it the way that they traditional way that we eat it. Okay.
And I put the.
And then put the coleslaw on the sandwich. Yes.
On the sandwich.
Yes. Mustard sauce, Michael.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Neat. No, so. In other school, I can get my friend to help me saying Chinese to each other, but in this school, nobody's saying Chinese to me.
So nobody?
Only sure. 4 Chinese students, but they in different grade.
Yeah. Okay, so.
Yeah, it's on my own senior grade. It's only me.
Wow, that's what happens when you go to a school that's 75% Chinese students to 4.
Mm.
Yeah, it's going to be a big adjustment moving to a new school.
It's good. I met a lot of friends this week. Yeah, they're very kind to me. They even asked me to go serve with them after school, you know, because I don't know how to serve.
Okay.
So I just saying, oh, I'm going to go home maybe next time.
Wow.
I didn't bring any swimming suit.
Did they have everything ready?
They got things in their car. I mean,
okay.
They're preparing,
right school, huh?
Yeah, I don't know.
Go to the beach straight from school?
Yeah, because they like living there, I mean, they're growing up by the near the beach, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, we'll have to show you how to go into the ocean water appropriately so you look like a local.
Joe has good at that, right?
Joe and Leo both did junior lifeguards, and Michael and I have done training in the ocean.
Training in the ocean?
And I grew up at the beach,
so
we can teach you.
Yeah.
So.
Yes, it's good. It's good new environment to me, new experience for me.
How about your SATs?
I studied that in China, so I'm going to take it again in this year, October.
Mm-hmm.
So,
October.
Yeah,
October.
October
5th, they registered for.
Yeah, SAT, one more time, I think. I hope it's last time.
Maybe another time after that.
But I hope it's the last time. I mean, yeah.
Who's got the lemonade?
You have until January, don't you?
I think the January test is the last test.
But for the UC system, you need to...
December.
For the UC, December is the last test you should take.
I want to get into UC University.
We'll do what we can. I think being at the new school is going to help your English immensely.
Yeah.
You have no one to speak to in Chinese.
I know, it's hard.
Good. Wow, Liam.
Liam, do you want the whole thing?
Yeah. What?
Want another one?
I would say probably the most thing that's been effective to me is the fact that I haven't had a room for at least 2 years now. And I was aware that I was going to be living away from home at college, and I knew that the situation was going to be happening, that when Alan came here, I wasn't going to have a room anymore at this house. So I knew that was the situation, so there wasn't any jealousy or anger towards Alan, because I knew that that was going to be happening. But I was able to make the most of it, and when I came back living here, and was able to kind of have my own space, and that's also kind of what I'm doing here, is making my own space, making my own room for myself. And I think Alan has added a lot to our family. From there, we've had a lot of great experiences when we visited China just recently, and we've had a lot of experiences in a lot of different culture from Alan that we wouldn't have had if Alan wasn't here. I'm working to make this into a room for myself from here, because when Alan first came here, he took over my room and he was living where I was sleeping. Since Alan's come, I've been sleeping in our living room, sleeping on our couch. Since Alan has been here, at first he was a little shy and a little uncertain, especially with his speaking English, and didn't speak as openly with a lot of people. But I've noticed over the years since he's been here, he's been a lot more confident. From here, he speaks a lot more confidently and openly, and has started to take positions of leadership in school and sports and a lot of different activities. Within a couple weeks that he first came here, we went to the beach, and I guess the bathing suits that they wear in China and here are a little different. From here, the bathing suits that Alan was wearing, very short and a lot tighter from there. And usually the more bathing suits that we wear here are a lot more just kind of like regular shorts. And for a lot of that, it's because as you go through the waves and a lot of through the ocean, they can take off of the shorts. So from there, at first, had to make sure he understood that. From there, just was able to give him some of mine, so to borrow from there, just so we didn't have any accidents when we went to the beach. And at first, going to the beach, it's I guess he wasn't very used to big waves and a lot of the environment of the beach. So helped him out a lot, a little bit at first. He wasn't very good getting tossed around a lot by the waves, but it was. Able to get a lot of improvement and have a lot of fun when we went to the beach there. And I remember one time when he first got here, and before he had an American ID, he would use his passport as an ID. And a lot of the times the cashier would ask, "Oh, where are you from? And you know, what are you doing here?" And he would, you know, usually answer back, you know, just kind of a little stuttered, not very confident, like very well. And a lot of the times he would look to me to say, you know, to answer the question for him. From there, I've noticed, you know, I would say especially in the last year, his English has improved quite a bit, especially going to a new school now. And he's answering all the questions for himself, not looking to me to answer the questions anymore, and answering very confidently and correctly with his English.
Yeah, I choose to transfer from here to my new school in senior year. You know, a lot of my friends say, don't do that. It's gonna be hard. And yeah, I think a long time that I didn't say the school here is not good for me. I just saying because of a lot of more and more Chinese students come, I may make a lot of Chinese friends, but that caused some issues. Like when we hang out together, we'll speak Chinese. Like for me, when I come here, the purpose is I wanted to learn more American cultures to fit in real American cultures.
Right.
And also what I thought is, it's my last year in high school. It's in my life. It's last year in my high school. So
last year as a kid, huh?
Yeah, as a kid. And then you just go to college and your high school is done.
Time to get serious.
You're never gonna start a high school again.
Right.
So that's why I think a long time, I think, yeah, it's time for me to make my own choice and to do what the things that I really wanted to do and make me feel happy about, because if I don't do it, I miss the chance that I'm never gonna do that again. And when I get old, maybe 30 years, 20 years later.
30 years is old? Okay, 20, 30 years later, okay.
Yeah, 20, 30 years later, I feel regret.
Right.
That I can do something that in my 18 years old, but I didn't do it. Mm-hmm. That's why I said, okay, I'm gonna do it. Okay. And I told you, the things you encouraged me a lot.
Right. Well, I felt that you were ready to move to a completely American school without any support that's given to the international students like we have. And I think that transferring to the completely American school, that will really prepare you for college a whole lot more than you could ever dream of. So I think it was really a good decision, and I'm glad that we made the choice to move you. Well, I get on the internet. Anything that needs to be researched is on the internet, and I just started searching private schools. Mm-hmm. And some of those schools, and the reason for private schools is, as an international student, you generally have to go to a private school unless you have a green card.
Yes.
Okay, which you do not have.
Yeah.
So you have to go to a private school. So I just went on the internet and searched private schools in the local area, and I started making phone calls. I called every single school that I could find that was listed, and then process of elimination. Some of them don't take seniors as transfer students, because it's really hard to transfer schools as a senior. So process of elimination, there were two schools that we had to choose from, and we went ahead and chose the school in Huntington Beach because that is purely American, whereas the other school was an international school also. I'm really glad that you picked our family. Yes, you came because you saw that picture of our kitchen, but I felt almost from the very beginning that you were a part of our family. It's you integrated so well into our family that it felt like we've known you forever. And so it's been a very natural progression. At first, I called you my Chinese son, and that lasted, what, for maybe 2 months? And then after that, my son. Okay, I have three children. I think that you're really blessed to have two moms. You have a Chinese mom who loves you dearly, and you have me who loves you dearly also. So we love having you in our family, and it's just been a wonderful experience. I hope that our two families are connected forever.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that your children will call me grandma, you know, so be pretty cool. Sweet. Now I'm going to cry.
It's going to happen.
It's going to happen. Wait a little while, though. Yeah. Wait till after college. Okay.
I know myself running very fast. I come to here, it's my chance. When I really get into football, I know like the stuff in football, how football really worked. They need a whole team. After when I know football, I love it more. So I continue. I was thinking, I really wanted to continue play football. Time gone, it's gone. Yeah. It's never happened in your life again.
Football is a very demanding sport. It demands a lot on your body. It demands a lot mentally. It demands a lot physically, emotionally. And I think that once you start to pick that up fairly quick when you start to realize how fast and how aggressive the sport was. And I think that it really helps sharpen you in a lot of positive ways, like it does with anybody.
这是我可以说这几年来最喜欢的一个地方，经常一个人过来看看夜景。这地方是我一个朋友带我来的，当时晚上他说你有空吗？有空出来带我去个地方玩一下，然后对，就带到这里。然后这我当时来第一眼是感觉是非常的，就有种说不出的感觉。当时看了这些灯光，然后我就愣在那里，愣了很长时间，然后就突然想到了很多事情。来这边那么久，其实说实在的，一个人也挺苦的。特别是第一年的时候，你知道没？寄宿家庭其实一开始就觉得，交了那么多钱到这边，以为会有一个非常大的房子，非常好的大别墅住。其实到最后，其实是一个非常普通的家庭。然后我当时，因为我很多朋友他们住的条件都比我好嘛，然后我就有种非常的失落的感觉，就觉得为什么别人住的比我好，我却住的不是那么特别的潇洒，对吧？但是后来渐渐跟他们的关系是，后来我当时有想法想转换一个人家住，但是经过2个月，我发现，说实在的，我看中的是他们对我的好。我妈也是这样跟我讲。我当时跟我妈讲了这个问题，我妈就问了我一句，他们对你好不好？然后我说，对我真的很好。然后我妈说，那就没有什么任何问题了。环境这些东西，有个床给你睡，有个地方给你洗澡， 有热水有饭吃，你还图什么？然后我当时说，对对对，我其实很知足了。所以说我觉得在美国找一个好的寄宿家庭，不是在于他的条件环境能给你多好的条件啊，能给你多好的房间，其实主要的是有一个像妈妈一样的人照顾我。这就是我觉得我到这边最大的财富，就是找到一个好的寄宿家庭对我好。对，然后每次我来到这边，情况都是我有的时候不开心，心里面很难过的时候，我会经常一个人跑到这边来。我还记得上一次过来是去年有一场篮球比赛啊，打得不是特别好，然后心里面非常的失落啊，觉得表现不是特别好。然后到了学校，准备从校车上面下来准备回家，我就一个人偷偷开到这边，然后就站在这边就看啊，看着这夜景，就因为心情不好就过来。然后不仅想到那时候就会看到这些灯火，我第一个感觉我会特别的想家。因为对啊，你一个人在这里当然会很想，最挂念的还是自己的亲人，然后就会想到我的父母他们怎么样，我的那些表弟表妹还过得好不好。特别是有的时候在我遇到很多困难，像考试考砸了，有的时候或者说犯了某些错误，或者说情感上面遇到一些问题，都会觉得没人去说话。然后都会，因为我虽然说表面非常开心，其实自己内心不舒服的时候就会一个人跑过来看夜景。我觉得这也是一种很幸运嘛，能够说在异国他乡找到一个属于自己想来的地方，诉说自己内心的想法。我来的那年我是16岁，然后也不是特别小孩，但是心里面还是有很脆弱的时候嘛。特别是第一年一想到家的时候，那时候自己会在房间里默默的流眼泪啊之类的东西。我当时我记得我过生日的时候，那是我第一次说的在这边过生日。然后我也想那也可能是我这以后7-8年吧，应该高中大学这7-8年都得一个人在这边过生日了。然后想到就特别的心酸，特别还有过年的时候，我知道当我选择出国这条路的时候，就意味着以后这些年对我而言就没有说真正意义上的春节的过年了。对，也没有那种烟花炮竹，没有压岁钱，就一个人过年的时候，我们这还在上课。对，所以想到觉得一开始会觉得很难过，但后来慢慢的习惯了。很多人会问你们留学生是怎么样慢慢适应的？我觉得说一句实话，适应只是时间问题，时间久了等于说也许你就习惯了，不管你一开始多么的不习惯，等时间慢慢的过了，你就会习惯这种寂寞，也许是习惯这种异国他乡的感觉，你习惯一个人在这边做事情，习惯了一个人出去买东西，习惯了难过的时候没人说话，这些东西都是习惯了，其实也没有说你能有特别好的处理方式。所以说我有的时候会实在没办法，其实有的话你知道吗，有些事情发生了，你不一定说你一定可以找一个朋友或者找跟父母去说，所以有的时候就一个人憋在心里，慢慢的时间久了就好了，我觉得。所以能偶尔来这边看看灯光，然后看看夜景，就会多站一会儿，被风吹吹冷一冷，我觉得差不多就好了。有的时候我自己遇到困难，特别特别想给父母打电话，但是也想，你说你打给他们干嘛呢？他们又 我又帮不到你，说实在的帮不到你。第二，在这边你既然已经选择了要出国，遇到困难你早就应该有心理准备嘛。所以我从来说打电话给父母，我从来没有说跟他们说啊，我在这里有过得有多苦啊，我有很多不开心的事，我都没有。我妈问我怎么样，我说吃得好睡得好，对吧？然后我妈每次都问学习怎么样，然后我就说你们放心，肯定不会差啊，我就这样。但也说太好呢他们也不相信，所以说我就说你们放心，我作业按时交，成绩保证给你们在 B 以上。这就是我啊每次跟我父母聊天都会这样说的。特别是在这个时候，你如果天上有一架飞机飞过去，真的你看着那个飞机，我就可以一直看着它，就会想啊它又要飞到哪边去了，我什么时候真的是我什么时候才能说的坐上飞机啊回到中国。在真正你上飞机的那一刻，你坐在椅子上那种心情，我觉得真的是又开心又特别想哭，你知道吗？就说啊马上要回去了，马上要回到中国，那种感觉真的是啊悲喜交加吧。对对，在这里我在国外的生活还得持续4-5年吧，所以我当然希望我啊父母在中国身体是最重要的。爸爸妈妈那么劳累的工作赚钱为了我，其实挺不容易的，所以我也得有自己的目标，有自己把自己学习生活都照顾好，他们放心就行了。等每一年回去都给他们看到啊不一样的自己，又成熟长大的自己，我觉得这样他们都开心，我也会开心。
很好。
Do you have any regrets?
No regrets.
No regrets at
no
all.
Even though I broke my
not
arm.
Not even a little bit. I mean,
not even a little
broke
bit.
Your,
I always
not just one
being like thankful for all the things that I have opportunity to go into America, like another side of the world, and play the real men's sport. I don't regret.
I don't regret. And I think for you to just, out of your whole career here, athletic career, for you to even come to that type of conclusion.
I mean, think about it, man. You had some bruises. You was tired from games. Remember those bruises?
I get hit by here. What's this muscle called?
What was it? What's your groin?
A groin muscle.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I was like, Coach, I can't even run. Coach said, get over it. Do you remember? Get over it. Oh my God, I can't even walk with
that. Yeah,
like,
bro.
Yeah,
Coach.
Coach D.
Yeah, Coach D, Coach man. He'll pull a lot out of you. Yeah, he's a great guy. Yeah, I remember you sprung your ankle out there a couple
of
times.
And Coach just says, get some tape.
Right.
Keep running. Yeah, I do, and then I swim in every night when I get home. I ice it. That would be, I mean,
right.
I still survive. That's why.
Right. Well, man, I guess I got a question for you though, man. Do you have a you experience in America, the American culture, the game of football? Do you have any regrets?
No regrets at all.
Not even a little bit. I mean, you broke your arm. You got sprained bruises, you got a sprained ankle, you had practices you didn't want to practice, you had games where some of those guys just put a good hit on you.
I don't regret. I'm thankful for all the things that I have opportunity to go into America, like another side of the world, and play the real men's sport. I don't regret.
And I think for you to just, out of your whole career here, athletic career, for you to even come to that type of conclusion says that Southlands did his job, man, and giving you a really good American experience, man. Yes. And I think that the experience you got here,
it's not like you can't even get it by money.
Right.
It's just the thing God put in your life. You need to experience it.
Right. And I know now you see why some of those practices was hard. They wasn't just hard because we wanted to overtrain you for that game, but we also wanted to make sure you wasn't undertrained for life, and for life experience and what life was going to throw at you. And what, I mean, you got a lot of life to live, and I think, man, the experience you got here is going to help you combat and live a lot of that to its fullest, man. You're a cool dude, you know that? Man, big out. Man, my guy, Alan Iris, you should have told him, man, how you got, did you do that?
Should have told him. Get my name, huh?
Right, you should have told him, man, how you got the name Alan. Alan Iris. Right. Yeah. He was a football player.
Yeah, he was football. But everybody was thinking he maybe joined, you know, the real football.
嗯，这个是我2010年来的，就第一年来美国的这个高中，它在沃尔纳特，是一个中文是核桃市，这是一个华人聚集比较聚集的华人居住的地方。然后这个高中我第一年来我不知道情况，所以就是我来了之后感就是满眼望去都是黑头发黄皮肤的。华人就是说很多是中国留学生，那大概在学校里面占70%-80%吧。然后我第一年来的时候就感觉我来了美国好像又再跟中国没什么两样。学校里面这个学校中国人比较多，渐渐就有很多问题，比如说英语得不到很大的提高，因为等于说在一个班上就全是大家全是中国人的话，上英文课的话就有的时候不懂的，当时就跟同桌一说，我说哎这什么意思，然后直接等于说就翻译给我听了，然后就是没有说英语学习的效果没有特别的显著。这个环境不是特别就是跟我想象中来美国学习的环境一样，进进出出在学校里面全是中国的文化，有的时候朋友一约就出去中国人一起出去吃烧烤啊，一起去唱 KTV。我觉得这种能够在这边就是经历的活动，我在中国也可以，我何必就是说在这边就是说这不是我特别想要的在美国上高中的生活。所以在第二年快结束的时候，然后我有一个朋友，他也突然冒了一句话跟我说，他说Alan， 我也觉得这不是我想要的生活。 然后这句话当时深深的就是触动了我，我就说，对，我也不是特别喜欢这边，但是有什么办法？还一年就毕业了。我说，那个朋友说算了，就熬熬算了，马上上大学，一个新的开始。但是那句话上完之后，我就一直在脑子里回想，我就说，对啊，我的高中生活，我的高中生活人生就一次嘛，而且既然已经出国了三年，我何必说的，我不想让自己后悔，所以说在剩最后一年的时候，我这一次我就很下定决心的，我就跟家里人写了一封信，跟我妈妈写了一封邮件，把我的想法全部发给了我妈，然后跟我的住家也说了，然后他们看完之后一开始没有什么太大的感受，但后来我说我不想让我的高中生活就是在后悔当中度过，我不想说我长大20岁30岁我反过来想啊，我当年16岁出国在美国上高中，却是接触了一个全是中国人的文化。然后这句话我跟我父母解释之后，他们那边开始比较站在我的立场上跟我讲，那他们说，儿子，那你就是说自己去找，如果说你能真正找到合适的学校的话，那他们就同意我转。所以在第二年最后的时候，我的住家和我们两个人一起在周围找了很多就是当地很传统的美国的学校，这样的话导致了就是说也让我有了机会在最后一年的时候我转了一个新的学校。
You're crazy.
Crazy, yeah.
Nah, I'm just playing. You know, to answer that question,
六点半又要起床了，7点就得出发。要不然两条高速公路堵得不得了，那我得刷牙洗脸去了。现在啊，今天上学了，头发该剪了，有点长，马上把第一堂课作业好像还没做完，得赶快过去跟同学讨论一下，要不然两条高速公路又堵得像昨天一样，我就会迟到，然后老师就会给我一张detention。赶快出发。我那个给学校的回执。这是我新学校的录取通知书，已经在那边上一周了，感觉还可以。对，我把这个交给学校，然后家长已经签过字了，就可以中午出去吃饭了。这是我妈给我从中国带的补钙的东西，但是我老是忘了吃，今天来不及了，下次再吃吧。 这是我生活的这个城市，大街上你可以看到人非常的没有说太多的行人，因为各自出行的话都是开着汽车， 街上也看不到任何的高楼大厦，因为在这一带都是很空旷的，没有说很，我就觉得很少看到超过三层的房子。像那边有一个超市，平常可以买点东西在那一块。这边有个 Starbucks 在我的右手边，还有麦当劳在前面。对，我家旁边大概就这些，主要的东西。你可以看到，这边人的生活都是住着这种，单独的小房子，有自己的小花园。对，马路上，现在这个点马路上没有太多的人，但是等你上高速之后，就会非常非常多的汽车，会堵得非常非常的死。这是为什么我之前说，在我没有车的时候出行很不便，所以就不可以跟朋友一起出去玩啊。但是现在住的这个，在中国来说就像是我们的小区吧。现在在等红灯，得加点油，要不然都开不到学校了。这是美国一个可以收cash 的一个加油站，一般的加油站都是刷卡，但我今天没有带卡，所以到这个加油站可以加点油，可以用现金。对，先加足够上学的油再说吧。对，这就是我一般加油上学。在美国加油都是自己加的，没有人给你服务，这跟中国是一个特别不一样的地方。这是91号 West 的高速公路，是我每天上学的必经之路。像现在美国高速公路平常的普通的都在5车道或6车道左右，很大的不同跟中国是，它有摩托车可以上高速，就是很多摩托车，你会看到很多摩托车在美国高速公路上开。第二点，它高速公路很堵，特别是我这一条，在如果说我不是在7点钟出发的话，哪怕晚个5分钟，7点05分出发都会堵得非常的厉害，所以我每天规定自己7点钟一定要出发，所以这样我就尽量的避免了高速公路的堵塞。在高速公路的最左道是一道可以叫做快速车道，一般情况下是车上有2个人或2个人以上可以进那个车道。如果说你一个人开车进那个车道就会被罚款，所以说我从来没有说一个人开车赶进那个车道，所以我都是在最右边这几道开始行驶。同样我现在开车上学是因为有的时候每天放学之后需要在学校留下来训练那个篮球或者橄榄球，所以说我的住家他3点钟放学之后他需要回家，所以我每天训练到6点钟，所以我就得必须得自己开车。像开车这事情我也是经过了我爸爸的同意，跟他讲过了，也拿出我自己的成绩之后，我爸爸才允许给我在这边买了，也是我人生中的第一辆汽车吧，所以我还是蛮珍惜我这辆汽车的。他每个月大概是一个星期加一次油，一次油的话$60，所以对一个月的话大概$200多在我这个油费上面。其他的我一个月还需要给住宿家庭1500的住宿伙食费，基本上我一个月大概在2000块钱左右吧，我的消费。因为我还有的时候需要跟朋友出去吃东西，对，有的时候买零食日常用品之类，所以大概我一个月的消费在连住宿在2000块左右。 对，这是美国现在你们看到的是这条高速公路，现在不是特别的拥挤，堵起来的话真的是从头堵到尾啊。
They're gonna count it, but I think
no,
it's a foul.
It's not a foul. Because he jumped so far away.
Just jumping high doesn't mean it's a foul, not a foul. You still hit a guy in the back, it's a foul.
Because he didn't do that on purpose.
Yeah.
See, Paul didn't know he's standing there. That's why.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. It's not on purpose. It's a foul. Foul all the way.
No, not at all.
Yeah, it is.
It's not a foul.Yeah, you know, when I play in basketball, I do that sometimes too. Because when I was doing the layup, if the guy is standing in front of you, I mean, you can just go and find a foul too.
He'd be charging if he had the ball.
But his back is on me, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not going to
agree. That's different.
I'm not going to agree with you on that. It's a foul.
Nah, I do play some basketball, so
yeah.
Maybe I got more experience than you.
Yeah.
I play for the school team also.
Yeah, foul's a foul, though.
Nah, it's not.
Okay.
Nah, it's not. I believe that's a good time.